some other madam took the another class. So I thought of a way to waste the time of half an hour or 1 hour. So I instantly created the Google Meet. It is a like urgent basis I created. Otherwise I would have shared in the group. Okay. Yes.
Yes.
Okay then. Ice cream. I feel my voice is clear. And the screen is visible now, right? Screen
yes,
is
sir.
Visible, right? You now?
Yes, sir, visible.
Okay, then
yes, sir.
We can proceed with the class now. Today we'll deal with some important aspects, which are called special horticultural practices followed in the floriculture or in the flower crops. Okay. We'll deal in detail with the crop wise. Coming to rows. In rows, we have n number of special cultural operations. Among them, the important one is bending. What do you mean by bending? Why it is followed in rows? You should discuss, na? Today we can discuss maximum.
Yes.
Okay. Why it is majorly followed in rows? What do you mean by bending?
To initiate early flowering.
Yes. To initiate? Yeah.
More flower bud.
Yeah. No problem. If it is wrong also, try to discuss. Try to speak out. Okay. Why you first think, first understand, the bending is mainly done in rows in order to induce the quality cut blooms. This is mainly followed in the commercial cut flower polyosis. Mainly followed in the polyos only, not in the open field. This has to understand. Okay. This bending is mainly done in order to induce the quality cut blooms under the protected cultivation. Okay. This is the one of the major horticultural practice. This is one of the major horticultural practice followed in the rows. 1 second. Hello. ನಾನು ಒಂದು ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಇದೆ, ನಾನು ಮತ್ತೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ ನಿಮಗೆ. ಹಲೋ ಹಲೋ, ಸಾರಿ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಇಂಟ್ರಪ್ಷನ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಹಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ರೋಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎವರಿ 3 ಮಂತ್ ಏಜ್ಡ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ದ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಷನ್. ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್, ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಡನ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಷನ್, ಮೇನ್ಲಿ 3 ಮಂತ್ಸ್ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟಿಂಗ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಸ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಒರಿಜಿನಲ್ ಬುಷ್ ಆಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್. ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ದ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ಹೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಬೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ 3 ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ವಿಥೌಟ್ ಬ್ರೇಕಿಂಗ್ ದ ಬ್ರಾಂಚಸ್. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬೆಂಡ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ಸ್ ನಿಯರ್ ದ ಒರಿಜಿನಲ್ ಬುಷ್, ನಿಯರ್ ದ ಬೇಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ವಿಥೌಟ್ ದ ಬ್ರೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ರಾಂಚಸ್. ದೆನ್ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ಅವಾಯ್ಡ್ ದ ಬ್ರೇಕೇಜ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಡ್ವೈಸಬಲ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಬೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ನೂನ್ ಆರ್ ಟು ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ 45 degree ಬೆಂಡ್ ರಾದರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ದ 90 degree, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ದ ಬ್ರಾಂಚಸ್. ವೈ ವಿ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ನೂನ್, ವೈ ವಿ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಬೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ನೂನ್? ಲಾಜಿಕಲಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ನೂನ್ ದ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ಲೋಯಮ್ ಸ್ಯಾಪ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಮೋ, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಈಸಿಲಿ. ಓಕೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಬೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ರಿವರ್ಸಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಯಾಪ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ವಿಚ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಫ್ರೇಮ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬುಷ್. ವೈ ವಿ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಬೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಬೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ವೀಕ್ ಶೂಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಫ್ಲೋಯಮ್ ಸ್ಯಾಪ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಫೋಟೋಸಿಂಥೆಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಗಿವ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ವೀಕರ್ ಶೂಟ್ಸ್. ದ ಫ್ಲೋಯಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡೈವರ್ಟ್ ಟು ದ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಶೂಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಶೂಟ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ದ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿ ಕಟ್ ಬ್ಲೂಮ್ಸ್. यस एस देव.
सर
वाई वाई वी नीड टू गो फॉर बेंडिंग मीन्स वील सेलेक्ट ओनली वीक शूट्स वीकर शूट्स विच आर वाटर शूट्स इन द रोज. ओके दे आर सो वीक एंड दे आर लैंकी इन ग्रोथ. वील सेलेक्ट सच ए शूट्स वील गोइंग टू बेंड एट द बेस लेवल इन ऑर्डर टू कट ऑफ द फोटो सिंथेट्स फॉर गोइंग फॉर द दीज वीकर शूट्स. सो वील रिवर्स दीज सैप फ्लो मीन्स दिस फूड विल बी डाइवर्टेड फॉर द बिल्डिंग ऑफ स्ट्रांग स्टेम्स आर द ब्रांचेस. सो इन द स्ट्रांग ब्रांचेस आर द स्टेम्स वी कैन एक्सपेक्ट द क्वालिटी ब्लूम्स. गॉट इट. दिस इज वाई द बिल्डिंग इज फॉलोड. देन अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट इज थिनिंग. थिनिंग मीन्स रिमूवल ऑफ अनडिजायरेबल ग्रोथ लाइक इनवर्ड ग्रोथिंग वीक शूट्स ब्लाइंड शूट्स आर क्राउडेड शूट्स आर वाटर शूट्स. ओके दिस इज नथिंग बट थिनिंग. डीसकरिंग इन रोज द रिमूवल ऑफ सकर्स फ्रॉम द रूट स्टॉक मेनली द शूट प्रोड्यूस्ड बिलो द बड यूनियन एंड द रूट स्टॉक हैज टू बी रिमूव. दिस इज वॉट वी कॉल डीसकरिंग. ओके दिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. दे मे आस्क इन द एग्जाम्स लाइक अ रिमूवल ऑफ शूट्स फ्रॉम बिलो द बड यूनियन आर टर्म्ड एज व्हाट वी कॉल दैट डीसकरिंग. मीन्स इन व्हाइल वी गो फॉर द ग्राफ्टिंग वील सेलेक्ट वन रूट स्टॉक विच आर ऑल इन डिजायरेबल कैरेक्टर लाइक इट कैन इट शुड बी स्ट्रांग हेल्दी टॉलरेंट टू बायोटिक एंड एबायोटिक स्ट्रेसेस and it is vigorous. These are the character of root stock. So if we select a good root stock, above that we will graft our desirable variety or the hybrid. So the only root system we can expect from the root stock, no shoots should be allowed in order to grow. So we will going to remove all the shoots from the bud union below the bud union of root stock. This is what we call desuckering. Got it? Okay, then de-shooting. De-shooting means what? Generally followed in the hybrid tea rows. You remember this one. De-shooting is generally followed in the hybrid tea roses. The young vegetative shoots which are developing from the axils of the leaves or the lateral shoots are mainly removed to allow the only terminal shoots to grow well. This is what we call de-shooting. The vegetative shoots are the lateral shoots which are weak in nature and the blind shoots which are growing just which are showing only the vegetative growth they are mainly removed. This is what we call desuckering or de-shooting. Okay, this is mainly done in order to produce the increased stalk length. Why it is important in rows? What is the importance of stalk length in rows? Stalk length is directly proportional to
with longer.
Yeah.
Longer stalk length is highly preferred in market, sir.
Yes, exactly.
For cut flower.
Yeah, that's how you should think. The length of the stalk is directly proportional to the quality of the cut flower. Okay. In the market, they will going to prefer the lengthy stalk cut flowers. Okay, then one of the another important horticulture practice in rows is wintering. What do you mean by wintering? Has anyone of you? Quick.
Sir, adverse condition is the root will expose कर देना.
Yes. Then why it is followed in Indian subcontinent? Why we need to create the stress in the rows?
Sir, better anchoring power in the soil. To anchor the soil properly.
Okay, then what is the main objective of wintering practice in rows?
Sir, when sir adverse conditions will come, then it survives in the field, not toppled down.
Okay. Mainly it is followed in the protected cultivation or in the polyhouse condition. we will going to create the all the favorable conditions for growing of rose. In spite of that also, we will going to give the stress for the rose. Why? Which are the other crops we'll going to give the stress apart from the rose? In pomegranate, we will going to give the stress.
Yes, sir. Bahar treatment.
Yes, exactly. Exposure of roots. This is also type of stress. Then in other crops, citrus.
Citrus.
Then in other crops,
guava.
Guava, exactly. But the main idea of wintering is mainly originated in European continents or the Netherlands based countries. Mainly this wintering is keeping the plant uniformly cold and frozen in all the winters to prevent the damaging effects of alternate freezing and thawing. In the European countries, in the winter it will going to freeze the plant, then after the, in summer it will going to increase the temperature. What do you mean by thawing? Have you heard of this word thawing? Freezing, thawing?
Not.
In the quick freezing method, post harvest technology.
I mean bringing the product from freezing condition to normal room temperatures.
Exactly. This is what we term thawing. After freezing, if you're going to, if the product we want to use in our daily life, like frozen peas, we need to bring them back to our normal temperature. That is what we call thawing. Mainly, this wintering is followed in order to adopt the plant, rose plant, in the European countries in order to escape from the damage effect of alternate freezing and thawing. That's why this wintering is followed in the Netherlands or the European countries. Prior to covering or removal of foliage or the any debris that might harbor the diseases for the next season. That's why we are going to remove the leaves. If it is in the freezing or in the dormant condition, if that plant contains some diseases or the pest, then it will going to destroy the whole plant in its dormant condition. In the dormant condition, the plant won't produce much of its defense system. It won't capable of defending the plant itself. It will be completely in dormant condition. The total metabolic activities will be lower. At that time, we need to remove all this vegetative part. The most common method used in the wintering is this method is mostly used in hilltops. Why? To lose well-drained soil or the compost mixture in and around the plant. This is mainly commercially followed in Maharashtra. Okay, this is the main objective, mainly followed in the Netherlands or the European countries. But what we follow in Indian subcontinent is different. That is what the exposure of rose roots in order to give the stress. Why we going to give the stress? If we give the stress to the plant, what will happen? It tries to survive. For its survival, what it does, it will turn its to reproductive stage. If it turns to reproductive stage, it will going to bloom quality cut flowers. This is what the idea behind the wintering. Got it? This is the whole concept.
Yes,
you need to remember this one. Apart from this also, that pomegranate, guava, citrus, that one also very important concepts. Further we will discuss in the chrysanthemum. Okay, in the apart from the rose, the pinching is mainly followed in chrysanthemum. What do you mean by pinching? The removal of terminal growing portion of stem, that we call pinching. It is done to reduce the plant height or to promote the axillary branching. This, the pinching of blind shoot is beneficial to increase the flowering. What is the main aim of pinching? If they ask,
to increase the actual shoot.
Yes?
To to increase lateral shoots.
Yes, to increase the lateral shoots. Okay, they will give in the objective, like what is the main objective of pinching? Mainly in order to promote the axillary branching, or the to increase the lateral shoots, mainly followed in pinching chrysanthemum. If they given rose, chrysanthemum, or any other similar crops also, if the chrysanthemum is there, go for the chrysanthemum option. Remember this one. Pinching is mainly followed in chrysanthemum. Apart from this, disbudding. Why the disbudding is mainly done in chrysanthemum? Yes, quickly. Bullet point.
To get disrubber flowers.
Yes, to induce the quality bloom. That's it.
Yes.
This is mainly done in cut flower. The removal of undesirable buds. It's called disbudding. That's it. Which we want, which we does not want, those buds are removed. Keeping only the central bud side. Why? In order to produce the quality bloom in the standard chrysanthemum. What do you mean by standard chrysanthemum?
Only one big flower.
Yes, nothing but cut flower, cut chrysanthemum. The removal of central bud is followed in spray chrysanthemum. Okay, in spray, in the cut flower, we are going to remove all the side buds. In case of spray, we will going to remove the central bud, so we will expect the bunch of spray type chrysanthemum. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then what do you mean by desuckering? That's quick.
So besides sucker to produce and we remove it.
Yes, why we need to remove the suckers?
To get more nutrition to the main plant.
Exactly. During the vegetative phase, the plants grow upwards. It tends to grow. The new suckers continue to develop from the base of the plant. In order to for the proper and vigorous growth of the plant, the suckers has to be removed timely. Means it tends to grow vegetatively, that too upwards. So in order to provide the proper aeration or the restrict the vegetative growth, we go for the desuckering. And these desuckered, the tips are used for the further propagation. Where all we go for the desuckering apart from chrysanthemum?
Rose.
Yes. In pineapple.
Banana, pineapple.
Yes. Then.
Rose, sir.
Okay, then any other crops?
Dahlia.
Then in the anthurium we will go for desuckering. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, that's what we are. That's what I am stressing you. Try to figure out all the difference or the all the common points in all the crops. Take a white sheet. Is this audible? Is this audible now? I'm audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. The main strategy here is you try to figure out all the common differences in all crops. You take a white sheet. Okay. You try to write out all the crops where the desuckering is followed. You try to list out all the crops where the disbudding is followed. And likewise, pinching. Likewise, wintering or Baha treatment, which are all the special practices is there, na? You try to figure out all in one sheet so that you can clearly make the difference in all the crops. Right? Following my step?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you do this. It will be beneficial for all. Then in chrysanthemum, we'll go for artificial lightning. Remember this one. Artificial lightning in chrysanthemum is followed. Why it is followed? Quickly.
So because chrysanthemum is short day plant, it flowers at a certain time, but when we need to grow it another time, means off season time, then we should
go for artificial supplement. Okay.
Yes.
In the long day condition, what will you do?
Long day condition, it will not flower.
Yes, that's why what we need to do.
Cover with the black polythene.
Exactly. In the short day, in the day neutral, when will going to give the artificial light for the chrysanthemum then?
In the long day condition, sir. Long day time.
In the long day, why we need to go for artificial lighting? It is short day, na? It needs short day for flowering or long day
yes,
for flowering?
Short day for flowering.
Then when we will going to give the artificial light?
During long day condition, we will give it artificial light.
If you give artificial
light. In case of non-availability of light.
Exactly. It needs short day for flowering, okay? If it is in winter or in rainy, where the climate is cloudy, then it won't turn to reproductive host. It keep on growing vegetative phase only. So, in order to induce the flower, we will go for supplement lighting. Got it?
Yes.
Here the mainly high pressure mercury fluorescent lamps are used. LED lights. Recently we are using LED lights only. This has been banned. Mercury fluorescent lamps. Okay. Overhead heating. Have you heard of this word? Overhead heating. Where we follow this overhead heating?
No, sir. I have heard only bottom heat root technique.
Where it is followed?
In hot beds.
In order to root. Hot to root cuttings, or we follow that technique. Bottom heat technique. Which crop? In which crop we follow bottom heat technique?
Mango.
Then? Bougainvillea?
Yes.
The overhead heat technique is followed in European countries. In order to maintain the temperature of the polios, we'll follow that. Mainly in controlled polios condition. Completely atomized technique will be followed in European countries like Netherlands. There, in the winter condition, they will going to create artificial heat in order to grow the crops. Okay, this darkening or shading is related to chrysanthemum in order to induce flowering. When the long day is too long for the bud initiation, artificial shade is provided in order to create the short day condition. Got it? Here we use polythene sheet of 150 gauge for shading. 150 gauge. Here the shading is done during evening 6 to morning 7 a.m. by covering these polythene sheet over the inverted U frames, like polytunnel you have seen in the nursery, creating inverted U shape frames. That is what we call polytunnels. Okay. Then in carnation, we'll deal in carnation. Pinching. Here in pinching, we have three types: single pinch and off, then double pinching. Why exactly the single pinching followed in carnation? Why the single pinching is followed?
Sir,
only I need bullet point. It should be like the option which is given in the in your competitive exam, like JRF or SRF or NEET or ARS or any other competitive. The single pinching incarnation mainly done in order to obtain the early crop. This is very important. Obtain the early crop. Why we go for the single and half pinch? Quick. I'm audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Why we go for single and half pinch? In order to get the uniform production or steady production of carnation. What do you mean by steady production? Continuous production. If we pinch single and half pinch, we will get the continuous production of flowers. You try to remember like that. Single pinch is mainly done to obtain the early crop. Pinch and half is followed mainly in order to get continuous production of flowers. Why the double pinch is followed in carnation? Yes. Why the double pinch is followed in carnation? Mainly in order to delay the crop, opposite to single pinch. In order to delay the crop. Why we go for delaying the crop? If the market is too glut, if it is crowded with thousands of flower, the market is falling, price is falling, then we will go for double pinch. It is not commercially followed. Why? Because the quality of the flowers will be poor. Got it? Yes? What do you mean by netting? Yes, quick.
It's like a support, sir.
It's like?
Support, sir.
It's like support. Why need to give the support for the carnation? Because the carnation shoots are, yes, carnation shoots are weak. They can't stand on their own. They are so tender in nature. So they will go for staking using the nylon nets or the chicken mesh at the size of 10 into 10 centimeter, 12.5 into 12.5 centimeter, 15 into 15. This is the first layer, second layer, third layer. Need to remember all these things. Okay. What do you mean by supplementary lightening? Carnation is short day or long day? Quick.
Long day, sir.
Qualitative long day or quantitative long day? Yes. Qualitative long day. I have discussed all these points, right?
Sir.
Then why you are not able to remember all those points? I have told you earlier only. You try to figure out all the difference. List out all the long day plants, all the short day plants. You try to figure out which is qualitative long day, qualitative short day, quantitative long day, qualitative short day. Like that you try to list out all in one A4 sheet. You stick on your wall so that you can able to remember all the points. You are getting my point? Yes or no?
Yes.
This artificial lightning is very effective in order to increase the shoot length, the flower size. This is what the qualitative long day means. It increases the quality of the flower. You need to remember this one, this concept. Okay. During the November and January, from the dusk to dawn, when the light intensity are poor, then we will go for artificial lightening in carnation in order to induce the quality cut flower. Got it? Then disbudding.
Yeah.
In disbudding, thus if we remove central buds, it will become, what will become? If we remove the central bud, it will become the spray carnation. If we remove side buds, what will become? What it become? It will become standard carnation. Yes. Then in anthurium, the leaf pruning. This is one of the important technique on the horticulture practice followed in anthurium. Okay. Why the leaf pruning is done in anthurium? Why? What are the minimum number of leaves to be retained in the anthurium flower, anthurium plant, to get the quality cut blooms? This is the exact question that you will going to face in the JRF paper or SRF paper.
How so many? One leaf, one flower. No.
That is the general thumb rule. If one new leaf develop or arised, it will going to yield one quality bloom. It means it won't, it will produce, it will contribute towards the production of one flower. Getting?
Yes, sir.
What is the minimum number of leaves to be maintained in the anthurium plot, anthurium plant, in order to get the flowers? It is, here is there, na? 4 to 6 leaves per plant we have to retain in order to get the flowers. Then why we go for the leaf pruning then? We can leave 6 to 10 leaves per plant also, then it will going to yield 10 flowers, right? It is directly proportional, na? If we leave more number of leaves in the anthurium plant, it will directly produce the more number of flowers in the anthurium plant. Then why we go for the leaf pruning? Logical question. Why?
Quick. But so the quality will be less maybe.
Okay. Then think logically.
Size also, sir, less.
Okay.
The flower size.
Okay. Further. Yes. Here is there, na? If the plant is too crowded, if the leaves are, have you seen the anthurium plant? The leaves, the large heart-shaped leaves, they are so crowded in the plant. Means, if the number of leaves is more in the anthurium plant, the plant become too crowded or too clumpy. So the little aeration between the plants. So the more fungi, bacterial infections will be more there. The pest and disease development will be more in the poor ventilated crop. That's why we need to go for the leaf pruning in anthurium. This is very important concept. That too, anthurium is mainly grown in cold climate or the cooler areas. That's why the moisture will be more there. If the plant is too crowdy, the development of pest and disease is very quick. Got it?
Yes.
Then this pruning of leaves will promote the flowering. This is logically, as this is scientifically, increases the flowering. One such crop is followed in the fruit crop, date palm. Have you heard of date palm?
Date palm. Yes, the date palm.
There also the leaf pruning is done in the promotion of flowering. In palmarosa, not in the palmarosa, oil palm.
Yes.
In the palmera, have you heard of crop palmera?
Yes, sir.
Palmera, oil palm, date palm, anthurium.
Yes.
You try to write it down, all the points. Then leaf pruning will enhance the flowering, then desuckering, in order to prevent improper or vigorous growth of plant. The suckers are regularly removed. Without desuckering, the plant will lose the vigor and become weak. That's why desuckering is followed. Then in gladiolus, the staking is very important. Why staking is done? Quick.
So to support it.
Yes, this is also very weak in nature, monocotyledon. It will be weak in nature. In order to provide the physical support, we go for staking. What do you mean by lodging?
sir, toppled down हो जाना
यस इन ऑर्डर टू अवॉइड द लॉडजिंग वी गो फॉर द स्टेकिंग व्हाट यू मीन बाय अर्थिंग अप व्हाई इट इज फॉलोड इन ग्लैडियोलस दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन ग्लैडियोलस व्हाई
सर कॉर्म इज देयर सर
यस इट इज मोनोकोटिलेडन फाइब्रस रूट्स इट विल फेल ऑफ इजीली That too, with a small little wind also, it will fell off. Right? And the shoots will be above 20 centimeter high. This is covered by heaping the soil up to the height of 10 to 15 centimeter. This enables the plants to grow erect despite of the high winds and the rains. And it also suppresses the weed growth, earthing up. The soil is must in case of light soils. This is very important. This is very important point. Earthing up of soil is must in light soils. Then this earthing up is directly proportional to suppressing the weed growth. Okay. Then in jasmine, the pruning is the important horticultural practice. Why the pruning is done in jasmine? Yes, quick. Mainly the pruning is done in order to encourage the
new shoots.
New shoots. These are all the basics, na? Why pruning is done?
Yes,
to increase the healthy new shoots. It influences the flower yield. That's it. Healthy shoots will directly influence the flower yield. In Jasminum grandiflorum, the pruning in midsummer. Remember the season. In grandiflorum, the midsummer, the pruning is done. What do you mean by stripping? Have you heard of this? Stripping is an important cultural operation followed in which crop?
Tea.
What is the harvesting technique in tea?
Blacking.
Yes?
Blacking.
Blacking.
Blacking. P-L-U-C-K.
I didn't get.
B-L-U-C-K-I-N-G. Black.
Okay. Then where we see in the stripping? Stripping technique.
Coffee things.
Yes, exactly. In the coffee, the harvesting technique, what we call, is stripping. Here also, the stripping is mainly done during the last stage of harvesting, when the all stages of berries are harvested. That's we call stripping. Okay, you remember in the jasmine, the grandiflorum, the pruning is done at mid-December. Okay, then in Jasminum auriculatum, during the December and January month. Then in Jasminum sambac, end of the October. Okay. And apart from the this physical pruning, you mentioned the how all the pruning is done in jasmine. Chemical pruning. Have you heard of this? The chemicals used for the pruning in jasmine. Used for the defoliation. Quick. You haven't heard this.
What, sir?
The chemicals used for the defoliation in jasmine.
So something chlorophenol,
Chloro? This is
chlorophenol.
This is very important.
Not sure.
They will going to ask definitely on this question.
Sir, auxin may be used na in the flower thinning method. Auxin may be used.
I am saying we are discussing about the alternate or the chemicals used for the pruning in jasmine are the chemicals used for the defoliation in jasmine, or they may also ask like the substitute for the normal pruning are the chemicals used for instead of normal pruning in jasmine. You write it down. Pentachlorophenol. You have heard of this chemical? Pentachlorophenol. This is the chemical defoliant used in jasmine. Apart from that, have you heard of potassium iodide? This is what we use for the defoliation. Then ethyl is also used in defoliation. Where? In which crop? Quick. In pomegranate? In citrus? Why the ethyl is used in citrus or in pomegranate?
Because it creates abscission layers, sir.
Okay. The name itself says chemical defoliant, means it will going to abscess all the leaves. What do you mean by abscession? Creation of death, creating the
yes.
death. It will going the all the leaves will fall off after spraying ethyl. This is how the stress is induced in pomegranate before pruning. Will create the what will create in pomegranate by using ethyl. Will induce the dormancy in pomegranate by defoliating and by removing all its leaves, then it will go for dormancy. Okay. Like that, you need to remember all the concepts, so it will be easy to clear out, or it will easy to eliminate the options in your exams. This will be directly influence the selection of options in your exam. Okay. For the pinching in jasmine, why the pinching is followed in jasmine? Simple. Pinching of, yes, this pinching of new shoots after pruning will helps to regulate the flowering. It will induce us the flowering. But in case of this Jasminum auriculatum and grandiflorum, it will delays the onset of flowering. If you going to pinch all the shoots, means then it will directs, it will redirects its photosynthesis in order to create new shoots, then the flowering will be delayed. Have you got the concept? If we pinch the all the shoots, if we remove all the terminal buds, the photosynthesis will be diverted in order to create the new shoots or the new lateral shoots. Hence, the flowering is delayed. Got it? Yes. Repeat once again.
Yes, sir.
But in other crops, sir, if we do pinching, then lateral shoots come and flowering also early come.
Yeah.
So here, exception is there. Why, sir?
You try to imagine. We'll first prune. After the pruning, the shoots will produce. If these shoots,
yes,
we go to we remove the terminal buds, what will do? The plant will going to produce the lateral shoots. Okay, this will take,
yes,
for the production of lateral shoots, it will take 2 to 3 months. This delay in the time will delay the flowering. Got it? It will concentrate,
yes,
on production of laterals, vegetative growth. Then this flowering will be automatically delayed.
Yes.
Yes. So,
but if you do it before, means generally we do pinching and pruning is not done, then flowering also increases, sir?
Yes. No. In the old shoot, the jasmine won't flower. This is the main basic concept. It will going to flower in the new shoots only. As in case of pomegranate also, citrus also, guava also. The new shoots, the new emergence in the grapes also. Then why we go for the pruning, pinching, disbudding, all those special horticulture practices? genetic
need
are
to.
the inhibitory. What is the genetic? What is its basic nature? First, if it has to produce the new shoots, new laterals, then only it will go into flower. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Then removal of water shoots. What do you mean by water shoots in jasmine?
Water shoots mean any branches growth which not given any flower.
Yes, exactly. Where you all found, apart from the jasmine, where you'll find these water shoots?
The citrus.
Okay, then. In pomegranate, have you heard of water shoots?
Yes, sir.
Water suckers, have you heard in banana?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Am I audible to you? Yes, sir. Now audible.
Okay. What we are discussing? Water suckers in banana.
What?
Yes. This water sucker, or the water shoots, means they are. These are also normal shoots, but they will grow very fast. Only vegetative growth is only followed. Only vegetative growth will be there. These are all unproductive shoots in the crop. In the jasmine also, in the pomegranate also, in banana. These are all unproductive shoots. Then this will simply waste the photosynthesis in the crop. That's why we're going to remove water shoots. Got the concept?
Yes, sir.
Then in the chrysanthemum we're going to remove the dry spikes. Why we need to remove the dry spikes? Dry inflorescence.
Sir, in Crossandra, sir.
Yes, in Crossandra. Have you seen the crop Crossandra? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Sir.
In and around your houses, you may have the plants of Crossandra. We need to remove the dry inflorescence or the spikes in order to enhance the flower production. If the dry spikes or the inflorescence present in the plant will feel that the flowers are there in my plant. No need to concentrate on my reproductive phase. If you cut off the inflorescence, it will shift from vegetative phase to reproductive phase. The only goal of plant is to reproduce. Got it? To increase
yes,
the, to increase its seeds or its daughter or sons in the nature or the earth. Got it?
Yes.
Then how much time I took? It's already 12:35.
1 hour.
1 hour. Okay then. We'll continue or we'll continue in the next class?
In the next class.
Okay, sure. The next class we'll discuss on post-harvest management of the flower crops. Fine.
Intercultural operations are in here.
Yeah. If it is any other special intercultural operation is there, I'll just inform in between the classes. Okay. These are all the major horticulture practices, which are all very important for your exam. That's why I told you separately. Right.
Okay.
Apart from that, I will show some slides. Wait. These are also important intercultural operations only. This cutting, layering, guti, grafting, budding, then this is netting incarnation, pinching, then disbudding, bending. This is what bending. In the initial days, we are going to bend the shoots. Then pendal system in grape. These are all special horticulture practices only. High density planting in mango. Then desuckering in pineapple. Then coppicing. What do you mean by coppicing? Yes, what do you mean by coppicing? Pollarding. Where we'll follow this pollarding? I think you haven't. Yes?
Peppers.
Peppers. I think you haven't read the plantation crops, spices, medicinal, aromatic crops, right? In the next class, you need to give a short note on pollarding and coppicing. Okay? In the mango also, it will come. Important food crop only, we'll follow these techniques. And in plantation crops. In the next class, you try to give a short note on coppicing and these techniques. Apart from what we have discussed, you try to figure it out which are all the other techniques followed in the crops. Okay, this is the special consider it may assignment also. This is very important for you with respect to your exam. Okay, we will discuss all these concepts in the next class. Fine. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you. We'll close the meeting then. Okay. Bye.